Thank you. Elvira, Mistress of the Dark, and here's to my big opening! And the show, as you know, is called Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. Yeah, because you know, it's all about me, okay? And besides, we did some research, and it turns out that my fans can even either remember my name or the name of the show, but not both. Yeah. I blame the Facebook. I really do. Or the Russians. I don't know. Okay, let's hear it for my ride, the Macaque-mobile. Woohoo! Yeah, you know, the Macaque-mobile and I have a lot in common. Mm-hmm. We both have high beam headlights. We've had little body work done. And despite a crap load of miles, we, over the years, our engines still purr like a kitten. Yeah, very funny sound, dude. Yeah, when I want your opinion, I'll beat it out of you, okay? Okay. Okay, let's hear it for my set. I'm talking about this one. Hey, did you guys dig that opening number? Yeah. I told my dancers if they didn't really get their move on, there would be grave consequences. Mm-hmm. And speaking of graves, this year's show actually has a plot. And not a cemetery plot. No. It's a story about a bright-eyed, bushy-tailed actress. Ew, wait, oh my god, that reminds me, I better make a waxing appointment. yeah, a bright-eyed, bushy-tailed, young, aspiring actress who goes across the country and winds up right here in glamorous, sophisticated Buena Park. And for the three of you in the audience that do not speak Spanish, that means good park. That's right. As opposed to Parque Malo, you know, that mouse-infested place in Anaheim? Yeah. Okay, but speaking of parks, it's time. Oh, speaking of parks, it's time for me to park my assets on my signature sofa and do what I do best. No, not that, you freeverts. God. Yeah, this ain't no casting couch, okay? It's a, oh my God, Mel, maybe it is. Who knew? Oh, and look, I bet you it'll fit for her comfortably. Okay, later, boys, later, okay? Boys, boom! Ah, I look forward to that. Okay, now it's time for me to show a bad movie. But this one is actually a masterpiece because it's all about my meteoric rise to the middle. Yeah. So just in case you don't know who I am and you just ducked in here to take a load off and get away from some homicidal clowns, I am gonna tell you who I am now, who you're dealing with, okay? So everyone just sit back, relax, put your legs up on the person in front of you. And let's take a little stroll down memory lane. I was born at a very early age to poor white trash parents who were so old-fashioned, I wasn't even allowed to wear makeup until I was 3 months old. The 15 years I spent in grade school were some of my happiest times. But like all kids, I went through that awkward phase, which sadly continues to this day. During the swinging 60s, I tuned in, turned on, and dropped out of high school, where I was voted most likely to by the entire football team. Right out of school, I joined the military, where I served directly under General Storman Norman Schwarzkopf in Operation Candy Shield. Time after time, I went down behind enemy lines, single-handedly winning the war. After serving my country, I did what any red-blooded American hero would do. No, I didn't go into politics. I went into TV, becoming one of the most sought-after thespians in the business. I said thespian. Having successfully hosted my own show, I left the roller coaster world of television for the real roller coasters here at Knott's, where I quickly became the most popular ride. Well, they don't make men like that anymore. Wow. Realizing that opportunity only gives you knockers once, I decided to display my big talents on the big screen by starring in my very own Robustus Fluffbuster.
Yes, she's got it all. She's everything you've ever wanted in a movie. A woman and a casserole.
We got us a couple more volunteers.
Great, just grab a towel and start that.
Elvira, Mistress of the Dark.
As you can see, I've really been around. But don't worry. That's right. Do not worry. Because I'm still groovy. I'm still happening. And I am still hip. As a matter of fact, I've got two new hips.